Just a week after winning her election, Kristi Noem is already grabbing national headlines. If you believe the whispers, South Dakota's congresswoman-elect is in the lead for a newly created Republican leadership slot, a slot that's being interpreted as an olive branch to freshman members and, no coincidence, the Tea Party. She joins us now from Sioux Falls. Congresswoman-elect, thank you so much for being here. And just right off the bat, is this a leadership position you'd be interested in having?
Well, you know, first and foremost, my number one goal is to be an effective voice for South Dakota. But I certainly am interested in a position. I campaigned on the fact that I wanted to be as effective as I possibly could. But ultimately, it comes down to the freshman class deciding who they choose to support when we come down to leadership elections.
And have you talked to anyone in the leadership about this? Simply because we're hearing from a lot of people that they do back you, that the people already in leadership, John Boehner and others, would like to see you in that.
Well, I've certainly visited with them and asked them about the positions that were available within the freshman class, asked them for their insight on what each role would be. And they told me in this particular position that I was the most interested in, they gave me some good details as well. So if they are supporting me in that, I certainly appreciate that. But ultimately, when it comes down to it, it's my freshman class who will make the decision. And I would expect them to send a strong voice to this leadership table. They're going to want somebody who speaks for them and that they make sure that they've got a real advocate sitting at the table and in the room.
Do you see yourself as an advocate for those people who were backed by the Tea Party, yourself included?
Well, you know, the Tea Party was extremely important in this election, and many freshmen and many other legislators were elected with their support here in South Dakota. I had a lot of Tea Party support. I think the message that I carried of smaller, limited government, less spending really resonated with them, and it was something we could agree on. So, you know, I certainly think that that is something that's going to be a factor.
One of your papers in South Dakota noted that less than half of South Dakota voted for you in your victory. About 48% was your victory. That's not exactly a mandate. Now we're talking about a leadership position, and yet the Republican leadership that is here now is talking about no compromise. How do you square that hole, actually? I mean, how do you be in a leadership that's saying no compromise, no compromise, no compromise, and still have half of South Dakota who actually preferred a different candidate?
Well, you know, when you look at my particular race, I was running against an incumbent who had been in Washington, D.C. for about 6 years. She had been elected by wide margins in the past. I would say 8 to 9 months ago, a lot of people in South Dakota didn't think she was in jeopardy of losing her seat. But I ran on the campaign that we needed smaller, more limited government. We needed to cut our spending. We needed to make some tough decisions to make sure small businesses could still survive and exist. And that resonated across South Dakota. We made huge strides in my short campaign. And I think all South Dakotans agree that they make better decisions what to do with their dollars than the federal government does.
Like so many that are coming into office, you are talking about cutting spending. I want to tick through three items and just try to get a yes or no from you, because these three items make up 61% of the budget. Would you make cuts in Social Security?
I think that we certainly have a Social Security system that is broke into the future and that we need to sit down at the table, have some adult conversations, and figure out how it can become viable into the future. So we need to look at Social Security, make sure that we're taking care of our retirees and people who depend upon the system. But for younger workers, that we need to look at some real solutions that make sure it's still around in the future.
So is that a yes, that you would consider cuts in Social Security in some way, shape, or form?
Well, if that was a simple answer, I think we would have had solutions before this. So certainly it's not going to be a simple solution that we can come down to and have a yes or no answer. But we certainly do need to have some adult conversations, which we haven't seen coming out of Washington, D.C. in recent years, come up with some real solutions to that question.
I'm afraid I'm going to get an adult conversation answer again here, too. But Medicare, Medicaid, and the Children's Health Insurance Program, should those be cut in some way?
Well, I think when you look at this health care bill, we've seen that the previous administration, this administration, has been willing to cut some of those programs through the Obamacare bill. So going forward, I think they're very important for people. They're very important for people in South Dakota. We need to make sure that they stay around and are viable for people that depend upon them.
Defense Department, Pentagon spending, you see any cuts there?
Well, I think we need to find efficiencies in these programs. And I think certainly looking at the leadership as well, they've agreed upon that, that there's always going to be efficiencies to be found in all three of these areas that you've discussed, and that we'll be able to do that and look at areas of waste. But going forward, all extremely important areas of our budget, they do cover a huge portion of our budget, and that's why they need to find some real solutions to them. And we need to sit down and do that.
And finally, less than a month ago, you wouldn't say definitively that you would vote for John Boehner as Speaker of the House. Can you say so definitively now?
Well, it appears that Representative John Boehner is the only one that is going to be running for Speaker right now. He's certainly a fiscal conservative, somebody that I could support on those values. And so we're going to be able to make that decision, and I certainly support him for that position.
And finally, Michelle Bachmann, another congresswoman who is seen as a Tea Party-backed candidate, someone who has already been in Congress, she is going to run to try to be chair of the Republican Conference. Will you support her?
Well, we do have a couple of candidates for this position. I haven't had the opportunity to meet either one of them, so I'll be looking forward to when